Hello, hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to a mail call video. It's been a very long time since we've done one of these, but I got some very cool stuff in this package I think you guys might want to take a look at. To be perfectly honest with you, I'm not 100% sure what is in here. I know what I ordered, and I know what they told me was in stock and going to be shipped, and then I know what they told me actually shipped. So I don't, and there was some discrepancy between the two, so I'm not really sure which of those stock reports to believe. So let's just crack this thing open and find out. Let's see here, we'll start right here. And let's just take a gander what we've got. And a lot of the stuff, what I'll do is I'll just show you what it is, and then maybe a little bit later in a little bit more in-depth video, I can kind of do some unboxing of some things. All right, so get the box out of the way because it's got a bunch of peanuts in it. All right. Let's see here. Okay. All right. Let me zoom in here. This is a wizard miniature from Freebooter. Most of what I picked up here is stuff that I was looking for stuff to paint while I was at Origins. And I really, really love this wizard model. I've been wanting it for years, and it's just a cool miniature. So I figured I'd pick it up. In fact, let me do a quick unboxing on this guy right now, because he's just that cool. And some of the others I'll do a smaller unboxing on a little bit later on. But if you've never... Actually, tell you what, I'll just let you see the back. There you go. Nice and easy. This is one of Verna Klock's sculpts, and just a really, really top-notch looking miniature, like a wizard floating on this little cloud that's holding him up, and he's got this really detailed book, and you can't really see it, but there's a magnifying glass on the book. There's some stuff down here, like some bottles and scrolls and things on the base that you can add on. Just a really, really cool looking miniature. All right, so I get that. Let's see what else we got here. Okay, got some paints here. I was out of some of my Reaper Master Series gold paints. I like to use those as my gold. Let's see here. Ah, my packing slip. Let's see what they actually sent me. Okay. Wow, that's really weird. What is on here is actually even more different than what was on the other packing slip, the other shipped slip that they sent me. So I'm going to have to get in touch with these guys and figure out what's going on, because they either owe me some products or owe me some money, one or the other. But we'll get that taken care of. But let's get back to the stuff here. Picked up some more dry brushes, GW. These dry brushes are fantastic, but man, they wear out so fast, it's not even funny. These are the best dry brushes that I've been able to find ever. But compare these to... Here's one. This is the old Citadel Large Dry Brush. This thing I've had for probably, 5 years now. Still really, really long bristles. Everything works great on this. Versus the new medium dry brush, which is their largest dry brush, and you can compare the two here. See how the bristles have broken off? They're nowhere near as long as they used to be. It's just the quality's just not there anymore. So you got to buy a lot more stuff. You know, I guess that's one way to get people to buy your product, is just, you know, make it to where it breaks. All right, let's dump out a few more of these peanuts on the floor here. Find out what else we have in the box. All right. Ooh, wow, that's something big. What is that? I don't even remember ordering this. Oh, my. My. This is a fun little item. I have been excited, and I mean, like, giddy with excitement to pick this guy up. And you know what? I think I am going to unbox this guy right now because it's just so awesome. Check this guy out. The Greater Damned One of Wrath from Helldorado. This miniature is incredible. Let me see if I can pop it open. I don't know if I can. Yeah, look at this. All right. I'm going to do an actual review of this guy, but check out that model. That is insane. All right. Oh, man, he's big. Man, he's huge. Yeah. All right. He has a tiny head, though. Okay, let's get this guy taken care of here.
Got ourselves a giant sword on that side, and let's see if I can finagle yet another thing in here. You know what? I can't, so give me 1 second, guys. Alright. We'll do it this way. Plunk. Stay on there. Alright. Blue tack solves everything, my friend. Blue tack solves everything. Alright, let me pull the camera over a little bit. Alright. Get this guy all fancied up for you here. Little blue tack there on the arm to fit that one in place. On the other arm here, I'm actually going to have to pull off one of these little spaghetti deals here. There we go. Plop that right in place there. Press too hard on the stomach. That's okay. We'll put it back in spot. Alright, get back in there. Okay. So kind of like that. And if I can get the other one on there, come on, stick. Darn you. There we go. Alright. Okay, something kind of like this is what our model looks like. Just a massive miniature. Actually, this is supposed to face down. I'm sorry. I was incorrect. No wonder it wasn't fitting correctly. Oh, man. Look at that. And that is like what you're looking at there is basically torn up muscle and flesh and stuff. Really an unbelievable model. I mean, that is just incredible. You see all the striations in the muscles back there and everything, and then the ripped up flesh where it's kind of come off of his body. Just awesome. That looks like a skull that's protruding out of the flesh right there. And these weapons, these are actually like wrapped around some of the muscles in his body. Like the weapons are part of the guy. That is an incredible miniature. In fact, let me pull something that you guys can get an idea of scale here. Let me grab a miniature real quick. Tell you what, here, let me grab this guy. This is a Reaper miniature. This is one I was actually going to put up for sale this week. But to give you guys an idea of scale, this guy is about the size of your standard Space Marine. So there's some scale difference, guys. You're probably looking about the size of, maybe one of the greater demons. Maybe a tiny bit smaller than that, but really, really a nice, nice miniature. Don't know if I'll actually be painting this guy at Origins, but he finally became available again in the U.S., so I figured, hey, now is the time to pick him up because, hey, it's just that cool. All right, so let me move him out of the way and stop, you know, gloating and fawning over it. First of all, let me get the rest of that later. Alright, so Greater Damned One of Wrath from Heldorado. Awesome model. Really, really looking forward to painting that up. Let's see what else we have in here. This is actually a paint at Origin figure. This is Reinholdt, the Gobber Speculator. Really like this model. Very simplistic miniature. Not a lot to it. Just a cute miniature. Just it's got a lot of character to it. Really, really neat little miniature. Privateer Press. It's a War Machine Mercenaries miniature. Cheap model too. About $6 if you buy it retail. And just a lot of fun. All right. So we got that guy. Let's see what else we have in here. Dump out some more of these peanuts. And apparently some miniatures too. Same time. All right. What is this? Oh my. Now we're talking. Some of you may remember. Yeah, that's good. Good job, Christopher. May remember a few months ago or so, I did a Friday afternoon figures on a company called Studio Miniatures. All right, and one of the models was this guy right here, called Cole, Human Survivor. But let's be very frank and honest, this is Ash right here. This is one of my painted Origins miniatures. Looking forward to doing that one too. He's got his little chainsaw that you can either keep attached to the arm or you can magnetize it to where it's not on the arm. Definitely looking forward to that. Got his boomstick right there. Very cool. Looking forward to that mini. What else do we have in here? More Heldorado here. This is the Alchemist from the Saracens line of miniatures. This is what that guy looks like, fully painted up and assembled and everything. Cool looking model. Look, that's probably going to be an Origins miniature. Again, very, very cool. Looking forward to that one as well. And then it looks like the final thing in here was this guy right here. This is Merc's Miniatures. I haven't talked about these guys yet on Friday Afternoon Figures, but they do have some cool stuff. I'll probably do a line or a Friday Afternoon Figures on them very soon. These guys are going to be at Origins. I'm not really sure if I'm going to paint this guy at Origins or not. They've got a booth basically directly across from mine, but this guy is just downright cool. And I got to tell you, it's just a nifty, nifty model. Let me see if I can get a... do they have a picture of it? Yeah, they do. Okay, look. This guy right over here is the dude I picked up. All right, so if you can kind of see that. He's got like this really, really nice autocannon chain gun type thing. This beautiful belt clip running to the backpack. Awesome stance. Just a really cool model. A lot of these guys would make really, really good alternates for Space Marine miniatures. Just a, they've got a lot of character to them, and I really, really like them a lot. They're just sweet. Let me kind of pose this guy there for you. There you go. He's got his autocannon type thing right there. Very, very cool model, but look for that to be painted up sometime in the future as well. But anyway, that's it for today, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this mail call. Like I said, I know it's been a while since we've done one, but this one's got a lot of stuff in it, and I'm going to go figure out what happened to the rest of the stuff, and hopefully we might be able to do another mail call next week or so, depending on whether or not they ship me the rest of it. But anyway, that's it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you got a little inspiration, maybe. And yeah, take care, everybody. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye, everybody.